Yes. Mm.
Then the upper lip fold class, below that is a groove, no? The groove that follows the entire upper lip fold. And that groove is the sulcus marginalis, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, the median, okay, the median, which is the depression here, class. The median, so this is the median subrostral fossa, okay? And then the median here, the depression on both sides, on each side, is an elevation. Okay, on each side of the median is an elevation, and this elevation is called as
pulvinar
rostrale. Okay, and then from the pulvinar rostrale down, no, sloping downward, okay, is a depression. Okay, so that this is the lateral. Okay, lateral subrostral fossa. Okay, and then a continuation of the sulcus marginalis. Okay, again, so the median depression, okay, so that is the median subrostral fossa. And on each side of this depression is an elevation, that's the pulvinar rostrale. And then on each side, okay, the lateral subrostral fossa. Okay, and then you have the internal nares or internal nares, that is an extension from the external nares. Okay, and then here is the angle, you will find there an opening.
Yes.
This is the continuation towards the tympanic cavity. So this is the Eustachian tube or the recess. Okay, so this is the upper jaw. Now the lower jaw, okay, of course this is the tongue. Okay, the only structure you identified is the perfect. Okay, so in the middle you have there the single elevation. So this is the
tuberculum
perilingual. Okay, perilingual. And this one, kanisyang single elevation will come in contact with the depression here. Okay, sa median. So that it will close. Okay, as well as beside the single elevation are two depressions, right?
Yes.
So because this will come in contact, articulate with the two elevations, okay? With the two elevations. So that when this mouth closes, okay, it comes closed in contact, okay? And then you have this is the lower jaw, the lower rim, and then the tongue. And then you have here, okay, this entire region here, no? This one. This is the laryngeal prominence. Laryngeal prominence, wherein you'll find here in the middle, okay, the slit, no? The slit. Okay, so that is the glottis. Okay, that glottis is going towards the lungs. Okay? Question?
No.
Good. Okay, so. Uy! Ay, kung patay ka akong hair. Matabol sa akong face.
Ari.
So, ikaw na lang baba yung arms.
No, papi.
Okay, so I will clear this area here so to expose the esophagus.
Whoa!
Oh, no, I didn't want to hold you.
Oh, no, I'm good.
Oh, here, okay? So that is the esophagus. Only a short chew, no? Oh, ngit-ngit na, ngit-ngit. Okay, there. Okay, so that is the esophagus. And then you have the stomach. This region here, class, is the cardiac region of the stomach, okay? So this is the only portion of the esophagus. And then right here, this is now the start of the stomach, the cardiac region, because it's near the cardiac, okay? So the cardiac region, sabaan lagi ko. Okay, you talk, I will be quiet. If you want me to talk, I don't want to even hear whispers. Effort kayo, plus gikutasan ko, ha? Okay. Oy, off the record na. Padayon. Okay, it's not part of the, no? So I've said, this is the cardiac region. Now, inside the cardiac region has a cardiac valve or sphincter, no? The sphincter controls the food from the esophagus towards going to the stomach. And this, from the cardiac region, you have here the expanded portion. Okay, expanded body, and this is called as the fundus. Okay, so from the cardiac region, the expanded body, that is the fundus. And then the rest is the
greater
curvature, and then opposite the lesser curvature. Then the posterior end of the stomach is the pyloric region or the pylorus, and it also has its pyloric sphincter that controls the food from the stomach going towards the
small,
okay, the small intestine. The first part segment is the duodenum, okay, transverse, okay, and then the rest of the coil, okay, here, no? So this is the rest of the coil, okay, up to this point here. Okay, now this one, from this point up to the posterior, is the large intestine. The anterior most portion is the rectum, and then the very posterior here class is the cloaca. You break this and then you will see the anus. Okay, so what you see here class is the cloaca. Okay, so you have here the liver. So you have here the liver. In between these lobes of the liver class is a sac. Okay, this is the gallbladder, an empty sac. Okay, gallbladder, and this is where the bile stored. Okay,
flush.
From the gallbladder you'll find the bile duct. Okay, that where the bile passes through, no? The bile duct and then towards the liver. But the bile duct you won't see it anymore because it is microscopic. Okay, and then you have the lungs, okay, and then you have the heart, okay, and then you have the mesentery. Now the mesentery, this is the structure that holds the organs, the visceral organs or the internal organs towards the dorsal wall or body of the animal, okay, so that every time the organism or the animal will move, all the parts will still be intact, okay, because of this structure, the mesentery. If without the mesentery, then if the animals will move, then it goes anywhere else, no? Okay, so with the muscle, this is the stomach. I will stop until I hear a voice. This is the stomach. This mesentery is called as the mesogaster. Mesogaster is the mesentery that holds the stomach or attaches the stomach towards the dorsal wall of the body. And then here, okay, when you lift the stomach there, class, you will find the pancreas. Okay? So that is the pancreas. This is the pancreas is more clearly seen when you lift the stomach up. But it can also be seen here, no?
That's
there. Okay? But this is the duodenum, huh? Okay. Okay, and then, while here in the small intestine, okay, you have here this one. So this is the mesentery proper or the mesenterium. This is the mesentery that holds, attaches the small intestine towards the dorsal wall. And then the large intestine, you see this? Mesocolon or the mesorectum. Okay? Then, as I've said, you break this and you will find the anus. Okay? And then also, this is the spleen. No? This one. Spleen. Okay? Spleen, where you see this beside the kidney. Okay, so this specimen class is a female. Okay, female. Now, this is the unfertilized egg. Okay, may gani na pa may gibilin, no? Okay, this is the unfertilized egg. Now, the ovary class, of course, contains, no? The unfertilized egg. Okay, so whenever I ask during the practical test, if I pin this, so you will not just answer me as the unfertilized, of course, unfertilized egg within the ovary. Okay? So if the ovary doesn't have the eggs class, this is just lying on its ventral surface of the kidney, no? But if this is filled with unfertilized egg, then the ovary will be distended and almost covering the abdominal region, okay? So the egg here, the unfertilized egg here, class from the ovary, and then it passes through the funnel shape, okay? So this is the funnel shape. Naputol ni siya, oh. Sumpay na siya. This is the funnel-shaped ostium, okay? The ostium, the anteriormost portion, okay? Now, this is the oviduct, okay? The oviduct. Okay, so ostium and then the oviduct. And then the posteriormost portion class of the oviduct is the ovisac. Okay, this is the ovisac, the flattened posterior portion of the oviduct that is also going through the cloaca. Tagayro ko kung tissue, nagtulo na. And then outside.
Ang egg?
Yeah.
Anus.
Cloaca and then is egg will be, the fertilization will take place outside the body, okay, in the water. Mugawas na ganina from the body of the female class, automatically the sperm, yan ang mga lalaki, nag-atang raman na sila. Okay, so from the time they are released outside, the sperm class will automatically swarm, no? Taptuka na dayo na nila. This thin key structure here class is the parietal peritoneum. Okay, so this is actually covers the entire abdominal cavity. Okay, kana loosely, no? That is loosely covering peritoneum. Now, the one that encloses each of the internal or visceral organs, like that of the stomach, kana liver, you see it shiny, yeah. Glossy?
Yes.
Okay, that is because of the visceral peritoneum. Visceral peritoneum, this is the peritoneum that is closely attached to the organ, wherein you cannot detach it from the organ. Okay, while the parietal, kanisha, this is the loose, no? That covers. Okay?
No legs.
Okay, let's see. No? Anyway, you'll find it.